Dear all, welcome to this tutorial dedicated to CorelDRAW, the ultimate software for vector drawing and image correction from Corel. In just 13 minutes, we will see everything you need to know to start using it. When opening CorelDRAW, its welcome screen appears with several options to start, including tutorials, news, and the latest articles from Corel. On Get Started, you can open any existing document or go to New Document to go for a new one. Just define name, the number of pages, and the color mode between CMYK and RGB. Then select the page size across several standards available and customize it in width and height. Set the orientation, the resolution, and then go to OK. The new document opens on the main interface under a dedicated tab on top with all its pages listed at the bottom. On the left, you have the toolbar collecting all the tools inside CorelDRAW. Some of these buttons show a dark corner, collecting multiple tools inside. In this case, click and hold over the button and release the click when selecting the right tool to use. On top, you get several bars showing options and properties for the current tool or selected object. And on the right, you have several panels you can use to manage your drawings and document. In particular, you can take a look at the Hints panel to get tips and help on the current tool you are using. If you find any of these panels closed, you can reopen these from the Window tab under Dockers. There are three kinds of objects on CorelDRAW: the vectors, the images or bitmap object, and the annotations. Let's see how to work with vectors first. Enable the freehand tool to draw freehand by clicking and dragging on the document. You can also try Live Sketch and Smart Drawing to have your strokes and shapes smoothed and adjusted automatically. With the polyline tool, click several times to drop straight segments and click and hold to draw freehand as you like. Segments and curves follow one after another until you double-click or close the shape. Use the three-point curve to drop arcs by clicking and dragging to define the basic segment, and then release and click to define the arc. To draw curves, you can use the Bezier, the Pen, and the B-spline tools. With B-spline, you drop curves by clicking several times, double-clicking to apply. With Bezier and Pen, click to define straight lines and click and hold to draw curves with the help of the tangents represented as blue dashed arrows. To drop regular shapes and circles, you can enable the tools between rectangle and polygon and click and drag on the document. You can also use common shapes to drop other shapes, selectable from the bar on top. With Artistic Media tool, you can drag artistic sketches, selecting trace style, properties, and width on top. CorelDRAW has several drawing aids to help you with your drawings. On top, you can enable and disable rulers, grids, and guidelines. You can change the measurement unit used by right-clicking on any ruler. Guidelines are very useful to take references at defined horizontal and vertical positions. You can drop any by dragging from any ruler. Whereas, use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. CorelDRAW includes several snapping options, all collected under Snap To above. You can snap to the grid, the guidelines, or several object key points, including nodes, edges, midpoints, intersections, and centers. Now let's see how to manage these vectors. Enable the Pick tool and click on any curve to select it. Then click and drag to move it, or use the black nodes to scale it properly. If you click once again, the nodes will change so that you can 2D rotate or skew the object. Move the central node to change the rotation point if needed. To edit the selected object appearance, you can use the bar on top or the Properties panel on the right. Under Outline, adjust the line color, its thickness, style, its corners and endpoints. Under Fill, you can apply filling in several ways by adding any uniform color or any gradient with fountain fill, selecting color and transparency level for each marker, and setting gradient direction at the bottom. With vector or bitmap pattern fill, you can apply patterns by either using vectors or images. Whereas, to edit the vector shape, you can use all the tools collected inside the second button of the toolbar. With the Shape tool, you can move nodes and tangents to refine the vector shape and double-click on it to add new nodes if necessary. Enable the other tools to apply nice effects by clicking and dragging over the vector paths. Always use Control or Command and Z to undo any action if you need. Let's see how to work with images. In respect to vectors, these are pixel-rendered objects that may lose quality if you reduce their size or edit these deeply. To import one, go to File, Import, and browse for it. Then click and drag on the document to fix its correct size with the help of CorelDRAW. You can enable the Pick tool to move, scale, and rotate it as seen for the vectors. Each image is delimited by a vector contour that can be edited and cropped with the Shape tool or other vector tools just seen. You can also vectorize the image by going to Trace Bitmap above, getting a group of vectors, realizing the image that you can manage and modify just like simple curves. Moreover, you can select the image and open the Properties panel to apply several effects on it. Under Transparency, you can apply Uniform, Gradient, or Pattern Transparent effects just like the shape fillings just seen. Click on No Transparency to remove any transparency effect instead. With bitmap effects, you can apply several effects and corrections. Click on the plus button to browse for the effect and adjust its properties while checking the image. Inside the Adjust section, you find all the adjustments to correct the image brightness, contrast, saturation, and much more. All these effects will be listed above in order with several buttons on the right. Use the pencil to edit the effect properties and the eye button to turn it on or off. You can also change the effect's order by pulling one up or down. To drop text and annotations, you can enable the text tool and click and drag on the document to define a text area under dashed contours. This delimits the maximum text spread as you type in. If you go over it, its contour becomes red and hides part of the text content. In this case, you can click and drag the nodes to extend the box as you need. Moreover, you can enable the Pick tool to select and move, rotate, and skew the text box as seen for other objects. You can also adjust the text font, size, style, and colors from the top bar or the Properties panel. make sure to select any text or changes won't be effective at all. You can set the colors for the text fill, its background, and outline. At the bottom, manage caps and customize the text characters and switch to paragraph to adjust text indentation and distribution. With the Pick tool, you can select any object and use Control or Command and X, C, and V to cut, copy, and paste it. You can also select and edit multiple objects by clicking and dragging over these. To see and manage all the elements inside your document, you can open the Objects panel. You can show or hide any object with its Eye button and block any modification on it with the Lock button. You can also click and drag any through the list to change its order of visibility, especially in case some objects overlap. You can apply several effects such as shadow, contours, distortion, and extrusion with the effects tools at the bottom. Most of these work on vectors and some on image borders as well. Select one and click and drag to apply it. If you enable the Extrude tool, you will add some 3D extrusion that gets updated in case you edit its basic shape section. You can adjust its direction with the black cross and its total length with the small white block. Always with the Extrude tool, you can click once on the extrusion and click and drag to rotate it, or drag from its green circle to rotate around its axis. Consider that you won't be able to adjust the extrusion direction after this, as you can see from the white cross. You can also select the extrusion and set its properties above, including type, 3D rotation, and color, taking the shape filling color, an independent solid color, or a cool gradient. You can also correct its bevels and add up to 3 lights from different directions. Use Clear Extrude to remove the extrusion effect. To save your project, go to File and then to Save As. CorelDRAW projects are all saved under a CDR file format with all your object properties and their placement over the document. Choose other formats, such as PDF to render and print the document, or SVG to upload it on the web. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our official website for other free tips and extras.